Hi, and thanks for purchasing the Happy Birthday pop-up book After Effects template. This is a customization tutorial video, and I'm going to show you how to input your photos, change your text, and also show you how to, if you want to change any of the design elements in the book, I'll show you how to do that as well. So first, let's take a little overview of the project. So you can see in our project panel, we have several folders here. Our elements folder contains all of the source files and the pre-comps for creating this template. You can see our background room. There's different book parts, the balloons, all the little pieces that make this template what it is. So you can actually go into these comps and change them if you like, change any of the pieces, change any of the colors, or you can replace them with something else if you have your own design elements to work with. So moving on to the pages folder, and as you can see, it has your pages in here. And if we can open up page one, take a look at that. This is where all of our animation is happening for this page. It's a little complicated, but if you are intermediate to advanced, you can go ahead and pick around in here, and if you want to change anything, you can. There's several keyframes here. If I select Control A, select all, and hit U on my keyboard, you'll see all of our keyframes here. And if we go back to our project panel, go to our render comp folder, and this just contains our render comp, the Happy Birthday pop-up book render composition. This is a comp you would render, and you would add your music to this composition. If you went to File, Import, File, and then just look for your music track, and once you import it, you can just drag it into this composition. Just select it from your project panel and drag it into your render comp, and then let's see, you go to composition, add to render queue, and this is where so you would add that comp to render it out. Okay, so moving on to the replace photos slash videos and text here. This is a folder that is subdivided into several folders relating to each page. All the comps that you need in order to customize this are in these folders for each page. So if we take a look really quickly at page one, if we go to the replace photo 01 comp, double click to open that up, and you'll see we have a photo frame. It does have a pattern alpha mat on here. So if you wanted to change this pattern, you can, or you can get rid of it and you can just have a plain frame. And so to add your photos, we'll go to File, Import, File, and you'll navigate to the folder where you have your images. You'll select the one you want to import and click open, then you can drag and drop that into your timeline. There we go. If you hit S on your keyboard, you can access the scale parameter and you can scale that down. Or if you just twirl down that layer, you'll go to transform properties. You can change any of its properties, the position, the rotation. And for position, you can also drag this layer in the comp viewer. So you would repeat that process for each photo composition. To change the text, you'll click on Replace Text 01, and this is for the text on our first page, page 01, right there, and it's the Happy Birthday. So to change any text layer, you'll double click on that text and just type. There we go, the resolution's really low. And if you want to change the font colors, the font or the color or the size of your text, you can go to the character panel and select a new font here, change your color with the color picker right here, and change your size or anything you need to do for the text layer, change it in the character panel. So if we go back to our render comp, you can see that our text is updated. And as you can see, these little tabs that are sort of holding up the text, they're sort of, because our text line of text is shorter than the previous one, it's a little bit off. So to change that, we're going to go to our back to our project panel, back to page 01. And you want to double click on text outline 01. And these tabs, you can move those by selecting them. They're layers called text bottom. And you can move those over right here. There we go. And if you would like to change this outline color, go to the change outline color here layer. If you go to your effects controls panel, you can use the fill effect. Use the color picker to change your color to whatever you like. And this text layer also has a drop shadow applied, and you can change that color here, the color of the shadow in the color picker. And you can just repeat that for each text layer or text area in your pop-up book. So if you go back to our project panel, if you go to the replace front cover text and photo here folder, you can do the same thing. You can import your photo and place it in the replace cover photo. And you want to put it under this mat, or this mat is really just to show you what part of the photo will show in the cover. Go back to pages and go to front cover. You can see what that will look like. So your picture would go in here, and then you would replace your text in the replace front cover text here comp. So the setup for each page for the text and photos is pretty much the same as I just outlined. So it's pretty easy to follow along. We have a few other customization options in here. If we go to page 3, you'll see there's a numbered candle on top of this cake. And you can change that by going to the replace photos and text here. Go to page 3. Open that folder up, and here's your comp for changing the birthday candle. If you open that up, select this layer that says choose left candle here, and go to your effects controls panel, and you just use the checkbox to turn off and on these different numbers. So that's pretty simple. And let's say you have two numbers. You want to celebrate someone who's 35 or some other number, 12, 11, what have you. You can go to the choose right candle here layer, then go up to the effects controls panel and turn on this other number and select this layer, the choose right candle here. You can see it's a null layer, and you can actually move this and it'll move all of those layers over. You can do the same with the left. Move that over. And so the next thing we want to do is go to our project panel, and we're going to do a search for the cake top composition, and it's in the cake parts folder. Double click to open that up, and we will have to move our candle flame, reposition that over that number, and then we need to add another one. So if you do a control D, or you can go to layer, edit, duplicate, move that over. Now we have two candle flames. If we go back to our render comp, we can see our two candles are lit, and now we have two numbers. And if we move on to page 4, we have this pendant in the background that says happy birthday. You can change that. So let's go back to our project panel, replace photos slash videos and text, go to page 4. And you'll see a folder says change happy birthday background pendants. You can change the, double click to open the happy pendant. And as you can see, each letter has its own banner. So all you would need to do is just select a banner and then hit control D to duplicate it. Hit P on your keyboard for the position, and then you can just move this over on the X axis and just reposition that as you like. And then you can do the same, the control D for our letter. Hit P on your keyboard to move that over. And we're just scrubbing this X position parameter to move it. And so if you want to recenter this, you can select all your layers except for the string layers. You want to keep those there. You can actually lock those down. and hit Control A to select all. And then you can, any of these positions, parameters, you can just move them over. So you might want to make this a little bit more centered if you do end up adding more pendants and more letters here. And of course, these are text layers, so you can always just double click and then you can retype whatever text you like here. And you would repeat that for the birthday pendant as well. And of course, if you need less letters and less pendants, you can always just turn these layers off. By clicking the eyeball icon and then reposition these so that they are centered in the composition. And I believe we have one more thing that we can customize, and it's this calendar. And if that's on page 5, so go back to our project panel, go to page 5. And double click to open the change calendar here composition. So you have some text layers here for the month and all the numbers for the calendar dates. And you can change those simply by just double clicking and typing in your text. And if you want to change the font or the color, of course, use the character panel to do that. You can also change the color of this background for the month label. And if you make sure your select tool is selected and select that layer that says rectangle background, if you go up to our little menu here, it's a shape layer and you can change the fill color here. So change it as you like. And this circle for the date, you can just select that layer and move it around if you want to change that. And this is actually a paint effect. So you can change if you go to your effects controls, nope. If you twirl down in the timeline, you can actually change the diameter of that brush. So you can make that brush stroke a little smaller if you like, or bigger. And you can also change the color of that paint stroke as well. And it is animated, but you can't really see it in the book. So if you want to move those keyframes around and so that you can see the marker sort of circling whatever date you have, you can absolutely do that. So if we go back to our render comp and go to our back cover, go back to our project panel, and of course you can replace the text for that back cover. If we go to the replace back cover text folder and double click on the replace back cover text composition, you can double click on any of these layers, their text layers, and then just start typing in replace that. And of course, use the character panel, change the font, change the color, and change the size. And we also have our back cover text outline composition. Double click that to change the outline color in your effects controls panel by using the fill effect and using the color picker to change that. Now, if you wanted to change the back cover pattern or this pattern's color, you can go to the pages folder, double click on the back cover composition, and you can see we're using this yellow chevron pattern for the background. If you double click on that, you can open that up, and that is our pattern. We kind of use this throughout the template. And this pattern is created with shape layers. So if you select any of these layers, you'll see fill options up here at the top. You can change that, change the colors however you like. If you wanted to use a different pattern, we'll go to the elements folder and go to patterns. And let's say we wanted it to be blue instead. We have a blue chevron pattern. It's slightly different, blue and white. You would select that layer, make sure the layer you want to replace is selected in the timeline, and then you want to hold down the Alt key while dragging that new layer into your timeline. As you can see, the pattern, the layer has changed, but all of our parameters are still the same, like the size, and we have a layer style. And we have a bevel applied to give us a little bit of depth. So that pretty much sums it up. If you have any questions at all, you can always email me, Marissa, M-A-R-I-S-S-A, at fluxvfx.com. And I'm more than happy to answer any of your questions, or if you want to leave a comment. And don't forget to also leave a rating. Thanks a lot for watching.